во все остальные.
To serve for a man is not a deal which you can devote by halves. It requires an ability to take a responsibility, a willingness to learn something new every day throughout your life. This is an art, prolonging the existence of civilization. People come to medicine by vocation, and they remain doctors for life. Medicine is a world, and here almost each man can find a place. But the one thing you must remember, the sooner you define your knowledge and determine your desire to be part of this world, the more successful you will be. A veritable doctor possesses a deep knowledge of life and the human soul. He recognizes any heartache and pain intuitively, and he can encourage a patient just by his presence. Many years and efforts of wise and experienced people who have not lost the desire to comprehend the new are required for the preparation of a doctor. The synthesis of technology, human intelligence, and intuition defines modern science. The stories of stars of Russian medicine, which laid the foundation of the university, set the direction of the flow of new scientific ideas largely within these walls. The fate of the city and the university is firmly woven into an intricate pattern. Here, you can see the generosity of Nobel patrons and the solidity of the famous Botkin schools. Here the legends of the world of medicine are looking down from the walls, and the streets remember the sound of the heels of the first students. Those who influence the outlook of whole generations believe that the university is their alma mater. The traditions of Russian medicine are born within these walls and passed down from generation to generation, and the atmosphere of the city causes them to be partial to the profession and life. Here, values for which time is irrelevant are formed. Receiving the high rank of doctor and proceeding to the profession, I solemnly swear to carry out my medical debt faithfully, to dedicate my knowledge and skills to the prevention and treatment of diseases, the preservation and strengthening of health, to be ready always to provide medical assistance, to keep medical confidentiality, to treat a patient carefully and thoughtfully, to act solely in his interest, to demonstrate the highest respect for human life, never to resort to the implementation of euthanasia, to retain gratitude and respect for my teachers, to be demanding and fair to my students, to support their professional growth, to have a good feeling about my colleagues, to turn to them for help and advice if the interests of the patient require it, and never refuse assistance and advice to my colleagues, to improve my professional skills continuously, to protect and develop the noble traditions of medicine. I swear, I swear, I swear.